welcoming you to the SSC, the Stan Sheriff Center, Hawaiian Tel FCU starting lineup, scrolling at the bottom of your screen, and you will notice a similar starting lineup for Hawaii here tonight as they go back to really the starting rotation that they featured for the majority of this season. And Hawaii on service receive in the opening sequence. Stein von Tilburg is dug up, but Hawaii will get it back with the opportunity to score. Franciscovich dump shot is dug up. Now Ben Patch, the former first team All-American for BYU, doing what he does better than anybody in the MPSF, and that's put one down.
How about the front row for BYU right now? Patch is 6'9", Michael Hatch, 6'8". He's the little guy in the front row. Bryce Jarman, 6'9".
Service error there will give Hawaii its first point here in the opening set. Yeah, this is a BYU team that is just massive.
Large human beings. They're also old, by the way. Average age, about 23 years old. Because they go on those two-year missions and come back, they're more mature and a little bit older.
Jennings Franciscovich sending that one long. Yeah, to give you an idea of just how far into adulthood some of these roster members are, five of them, according to head coach Sean Olmsted, are married. There's an overpass from Hawaii, and Price Jarman, a 6'9 sophomore from Las Vegas, Nevada, pounds it home. He's averaging 1.47 kills per set. And that, in a nutshell, Chris, epitomizes what has been an issue for Hawaii this season: service receiving and the overall passing game.
Exactly. They were up against teams that are great serving teams. Here's another overpass. That one on off of a jump float.
And so it's 4-1 right off the bat for Charlie Wade's crew. This is a team that won 9 of their first 10, talking about the Rainbow Warriors. Since then, they've lost 6 of 7, and in fact, riding a 3-match losing streak. Backside set goes to Kupono Fei, and he's able to hammer it down to the Terraflex for a Hawaii point.
He looked very sharp there. He's getting the swing on the right side now. He's flipped positions with Siki Zarkovich. He starts right behind Jennings Franciscus, catches a split block right there. He loves that. All hitters love that.
So Kupono will serve. Took a little something off. The pass by Jake Langlois is an overpass. Unable to put it down, though, with Zarkovich. And that's going to be a fourth hit by BYU. So Hawaii getting the point there. A little miscommunication on the Cougars' side. And it's 3-4. BYU ranks second in the country, 14-2 overall, 10-2 in the MPSF, under first-year head coach Sean Olmsted, who comes over after serving as the head coach for the women's program for several years. Patch goes off the block, and no Hawaii defensive players able to make anything out of that first touch.
But the play-by-play announcer made a great play. There's a touch right there, and Kanoa Lee gets the next touch. I don't think we see it, but it was perfectly played, in my opinion.
As Patch with the serve. Yeah, we robbed the viewers an opportunity to see something really special there. That was pretty special, though, coming from Ian McKellar, the southpaw. Gives such a different look for this Hawaii offense coming from the left side in the middle.
See what happens when Hawaii gets a good pass. They can run the middle, the left, the right. They can run a Bic out of the back row or a D-ball out of the back right.
So 4-5. Here's McKellar. He can do some damage from back there. Good first touch by BYU, and then the quick set to Price Jarman. Bombs away.
Sean Olmsted calls him maybe the hardest worker in the gym. It's a great set from Leo Durkin right there. Jarman just buries that.
Hawaii ranked 7th in the country. They're 10-7, 5-7. In the MPSF. That serve goes long. And this is a Hawaii team, Chris, that is trying to find itself after having an extreme level of confidence coming into the season, coming off of that great year last year, 9-1 to start this season, but once again having to climb the ladder to a level of high confidence, and that is certainly a tough assignment in this stretch of the MPSF schedule. Brendan Sander, 6'4 sophomore from Huntington Beach, California, with the blasty blast there for the Cougars.
Great story on Brendan Sander. He was at one of the opposing team's gyms one time this year, and he was back to serve, and right before he served, they said, "You're not your brother. You're not as good as your brother." So he serves up an ace, and they said something like, you're okay. Then he serves up another ace. They said, you're better than your brother.
Gotta love that.
Apparently he gets that in every opposing team's gym.
Hendrick Mole with that kill for Hawaii, by the way. But yeah, Brendan Sander, the younger brother of Taylor Sander, who terrorized opponents in the MPSF from 2011 to 2014. Langlois swooping in from the back row. He was able to put it down for a BYU point.
Great story on Jake Langlois. Never played high school volleyball. I don't think I've ever seen that in the media guide of a Division I team like this, as good as this. Never played high school volleyball. Came out and tried out for the BYU team. And at 6'10", he dropped his golf clubs and said, okay, I guess I'll play some volleyball.
Yeah, he was a golf and soccer player in high school. Back row, here's Siki Zarkovich. Zarkovich having himself quite the senior year. He is currently third in the MPSF conference. Tops on the team with 3.8 kills per set.
Siki got the kill there, but he did not fool the BYU block. Three blockers up on him. They're keying on the guy who's got more kills than anybody else in this Rainbow Warrior team.
Hendrick Mole with the serve. Outside set goes to Patch. And did you see how high Ben Patch got on that swing?
He's 6'9", as if he, you know, he's 6'9", so that should be enough. But no, he's got 6'9", with hops.
I mean, this is a BYU offense that goes to the pins repeatedly, so it's not as though they're catching people by surprise. They're just able to swing over the blocks even when the blocks are there. Here's Pat from the other side. One hand saved by Kanetake. Great save out of the table across the way by Kuponofei. We play on. Now Patch against a solo block, and he just gobbles it up.
Patch says, you know, you guys may slow me down on one attack, but if I get a second shot at it, here's where they save it right here, Kanetake. Probably should have put two hands on that. And then at the end, here comes Ben Patch finishing one-on-one. 6'9 Patch versus 6'3 Kupono. Not a match.
Here's Kupono on the outside against a double block.
Great swing
by Sander. And a good second touch by Leo Durkin. And a free ball here for Hawaii. Jennings Franciscovich goes D-set to Stein von Tilburg. And he is roofed. Von Tilburg arguing the point. He thought maybe it went off the block and out. It is a point for BYU, and it is their largest lead of this opening set. As Michael Hatch, the elder statesman of this team, if you will, the lone senior getting regular run here for BYU, steps into the front row at the middle blocker position. 6'8 senior from Agoura Hills, California. Miss serve there, and Hawaii gets it back.
And that's where a lot of the leadership comes from on this team, is from the oldest guy, Michael Hatch, the only senior among the starters, as you said.
Jennings Franciscovich back in the starting lineup after giving way to Joe Worsley in the last match for Hawaii against Long Beach State. There's BYU going to work on the pins again. Jake Langlois putting it down. 6'10 junior from San Jose, California.
6'10. Can you imagine him swinging a golf club, too? There he goes. Over the block, which these guys just seem to do with regularity.
Hatch with the serve. Here's McKellar from the middle, and he pumps it long for a point for BYU. I mean, the Cougars are the embodiment of the evolution of this game of collegiate volleyball, are they not?
Yes. Large being the main word there, the key word. You know, especially, you know, they've got three guys that work out regularly with the national team, and they're just so good at what they do in every position.
And the block there by Ben Patch.
Now Ben Patch, I was talking to Coach Olmsted about Ben Patch. He said, actually about Hatch. He said Michael Hatch, who is serving now, one of the best blockers in the country.
Well, the guys up front doing the job there. Bryce Jarman and Ben Patch, and BYU gets to 15 in a hurry. A 4-0 Cougar run. Timeout. Welcome back. Let's take a look at the Kaiser Permanente keys to the match, Chris.
Well, for BYU, they got to pump up their serves there. It's 57 service aces. They have the lowest in the MPSF. Sean Olmsted said they're going to start tossing the ball up a little bit lower, trying to keep the ball in play, and that's a huge block get the job done. And for Hawaii, beware the block. Yeah, that's the BYU block that is the best in the MPSF at 3.5 blocks per set. And so far, And they've got the three blocks right now. There's Sean Bradley.
Yeah, as we return to live action, a service error out of the timeout for BYU. Sean Bradley, former BYU and NBA center, 7'6". And remember back in the day when it was 6'5", Tim Shepard, D'ing him up in the post for Hawaii?
That's right. We'll have to send Ryan Tsuji over to him and find out why he's here. Does he like volleyball? Does he have relatives on the team?
Well, BYU, it's a fraternity that certainly maintains the connection with the alums, and we're seeing it here with Sean Bradley showing up at the arena. You see Langlois.
How about these numbers at the halfway point in the first set? BYU, 10 kills, no errors in 12 tries, hitting 833. In Hawaii, 5 kills, 4 errors, hitting 077.
BYU siding out at an 87% clip. It is 10 serving 16. Keller with the serve. Pass by Sander. Set goes to Jarman, and he's blocked the roof. Access denied. Hendrik Moll and Stein von Tilber.
Very alert block there. Stein von Tilber sneaking in to help out Hendrik Moll on that block. Hawaii picks up their first block of the night. Last week against Long Beach State, took them 3 sets to get a block.
Good first touch there by Langlois. Back row set goes to Sander, and the stuff is there again. Hendrik Moll in the middle of it all.
Well, what a difference from last week.
And a timeout taken by BYU. Hawaii trying to creep back in.
OC Sports, presented on Oceanic Time Warner Cable, is sponsored by Bank of Hawaii and Kaiser Permanente.
Welcome back. Out of the timeout, Hawaii still serving on a 3-0 run, trying to get back into this opening set. 12 serving 16, Ian McKellar with the southpaw swing. The pass by Sander. Left side, it goes to Langlois off the touch. McKellar the save. Franciskovic goes out to Zarkovic. And a good dig by Sander. Langlois on the second touch with the swing. But von Tilber was ready, waiting, and able to block it back.
Three blocks in a row now for the Rainbow Warriors. Same number of blocks that BYU has. Rainbow's crawling out of a deep hole.
4-0 Rainbow run. McKellar almost handcuffed Langlois. The bump set is a pretty good one. A lot of net contact. And finally, the official Ernie Ho was almost convinced by the Hawaii reaction to blow the whistle. And so a net violation. And looky here, Chris. A 5-0 Hawaii run has them back to within two.
He goes up to contact the ball here. He touches the net and actually touched the antenna is what the call was. The outside of the net, outside the antenna is okay.
Set this time goes backside. Patch comes flying in. And he's able to restore order from the BYU perspective. By the way, the officiating crew, Ron Stahl up on top of the ladder. Ernie Ho, we just heard from. And Sam Montalvo and Kevin Chun, the line judges.
Appropriate verb describing Ben Patch. Flying.
Yeah. He can absolutely elevate, there's no doubt. Here's Siki off the block, kept alive by von Tilber. Franciskovic goes to Zarkovic again, and he's able to plug it through a triple block by BYU. Point Hawaii back to within two.
Siki's so good at finding a way to squeeze the ball through. Usually he goes down the line, and they gave him a lot of line to work with. They know he's a cross-court hitter. He managed to get that one through. Hawaii on a 6-1 scoring run.
And von Tilberg will serve, and he delivers an ace. His 14th ace of the season, ranking him first on the team. Largest lead for BYU in this first set was 7. It is now 1. Forces the overpass. Franciskovic goes back row to fade. That's dug up nicely by Eric Sykes. Here's Patch off the block and down. When in doubt, right?
When in doubt, set Patch. Pitch it to Patch, he'll deliver.
Was the AVCA Newcomer of the Year and first-team All-American as a freshman in 2013, then went on his two-year LDS mission. He is now back with a vengeance. Outside, here's Siki off the high hands. Patch there to save it. Set goes outside. Oh, Sander got way up the ladder. Great diving save, Kobe Kanetake. Free ball coming here for the Cougars. Set goes outside again to Sander. And he puts it down. MPSF all-freshman team. Now a sophomore. And from that esteemed Huntington Beach High School program, timeout taken by Charlie Wade. Hawaii got to within one, but BYU creating a tad bit of breathing room once again here at this late juncture of the opening set.
The last year Sander played in Huntington Beach, that's the year they went 40-0. Imagine a team with Sander, Tuaninga, and DeFalco. Are you kidding me?
That's just unfair. Well, while we have a break in the action, let's take a look at tonight's Jack Fact. A rare feat, BYU, one of only three schools to have a winning record versus the Rainbow Warriors. They're 36-19 overall. The others, this took us a little while. Steve Jackson, who comes up with these great tidbits, he asked us if we could come up with the other two. We got UCLA, but he had to give us Pepperdine. Yeah, UCLA and Pepperdine, the only other two teams to hold an all-time series lead against Hawaii. You had guessed USC. I had gone with Stanford.
And we both agreed on UCLA.
Yeah.
But I forgot about Pepperdine. I guess it's because they were losing 0-2 tonight to UCSD, the team that's winless in the MPSF this year.
Yeah, can you believe that? So that one actually we're hearing has gone to a fifth. And UCSD, must we remind you, has not won an MPSF match since 2014. They take nationally ranked Pepperdine. First off, they go up 2-0 in the match, then they take them to a fifth. We'll see what happens there. For BYU, this is a team, again, 14-2 overall, 10-2 in the MPSF, and closing in on clinching a spot in the MPSF postseason. Long Beach State and Stanford, both at 12-2 entering the week in league. They have already clinched playoff spots. BYU, with a couple of wins here in Honolulu, could do the same under first-year head coach Sean Olmsted. And what about the run they're on? 10 straight wins without losing a single set in any of those matches. Here's Patch. Oh, boy, he reared back a little bit more to pummel that one.
He is so athletic. Recruited by SC, UCLA, Stanford, Irvine, Santa Barbara, and Hawaii.
7 kills on 8 swings. No errors for Ben Patch, hitting 875. Franciscovich tried to catch him off guard, but Patch was there. And then Sander, the awkward jump, couldn't get it over the twine. So a point for Hawaii, 17 serving 20, and Siki Zarkovich taking the trek back behind the service line, where he entered the match tied for first with 13 service aces. Boy, they could use a couple right now. Alas, not to be, service error, and it belongs to BYU, now up 4.
Well, if you're gonna even challenge this BYU team, in my opinion, you've got to go back to the service line and rip away, like Ian McKellar did to have that nice little run. If you don't get BYU in passing trouble, you're in deep trouble.
Franciscovich again on the second touch. BYU ready. Here's Patch off the high hands. First touch by Siki. So Franciscovich goes to Stein. And he was bottled up. The roof was there. Michael Hatch, second in the MPSF in blocks per set, was teamed up on that opposite pin with Brendan Sander. And it's a 5-point advantage for the Cougars. Another timeout taken by Charlie Wade.
I asked Sean Olmsted yesterday about Michael Hatch, and he said, you know, he's not the greatest jumper, not the greatest guy side to side, but he has amazing hands and what makes him a great blocker. 2 times he's been up for blocker of the year in the country in his career, so he continues to have his blocking ways at the net.
Take a look at the series record sponsored by Aston Hotels and Resorts. This might not catch you off guard. BYU leads the series 36-19, which was part of our Jack Pack just moments ago. But the last meeting was actually in Provo, and it went five. Very exciting. And remember, last year, Hawaii was riding a 16-match win streak going into its final MPSF regular season series in Provo. And BYU busted that streak, winning in four on the opening night and then winning in five on night two as an entree into the postseason for Hawaii.
Yeah, and this BYU team is so tough at Smith Fieldhouse, and I know Charlie Wade was licking his chops to get him to get to play up this year at the Stan Sheriff Center, but they built up such a head of steam with these 10 straight matches in a row, not to even lose a set. It's been pretty impressive. They're playing about as good a volleyball as anyone in the country, including Long Beach State, who was phenomenal last week.
Let's check in quickly with Ryan Kalesuji. Ryan.
Well, the Hawaii coaching staff talking to their players about the block. Head coach Charlie Wade pretty happy with the way that Hawaii is getting a lot of hands on the block. He's saying the defense in the backcourt needs to make better adjustments with their feet. He's saying that the backcourt is what's letting them down right now. Back to you guys.
Thanks a lot. By the way, to your point, Chris, about how tough BYU is in Provo, 50-5 at home since the start of 2013. Just saying. Kupono Fei, goes hard angle, and it's ruled in for an oh-so-important and much-needed Hawaii point.
Nice set by Jennings Franciscovich. Fei turning, did a little wrist-away shot. He normally likes to hit that line, but they took his line away, so he took what they gave him, the cross-court angle.
Joe Worsley in with the serve for Hawaii. Langlois from the back row. Good save by Von Tilburg. Here's Seiki. Missed the court wide. No, they will rule that in. Line judge called it out. But Ron Stahl upstairs ruled it in, so it is a point for the Rainbow Warriors.
You know, I like the referees who are watching the ball the entire time and make the occasional overrule. And Ron Stahl did that just then.
So 19 serving 22. Here it comes from Worsley. First touch by Sykes. Outside it goes to Patch up the elevator. Off the block, kept alive by Zarkovic. Franciscovic goes to Fei. Oh, there was a hot stream of smoke off of that Kupono Fei swing. And it hit the scoreboard off of the first dig. And so it's a Hawaii point. Timeout taken by Sean Olmsted as the Rainbow Warriors are putting up a fight here on this Wednesday edition.
Is it just me, or do the miles per hour per swing just seem a little bit higher this weekend?
They're packing some punches out there, there's no doubt.
I think they get inspired by watching Brendan Sander and Ben Patch when they swing, so Seiki and Kupono Fei are up in their game as well.
We'll make the dream of education a reality for our student athletes. Visit HawaiiAthletics.com and click on the donate button in the Ahahui Koa Anui Nui banner. And a reminder on that last Hawaii point, again, it was the blazing Kupono Fei swing. But the first dig hit the scoreboard and then wound up on the Hawaii side of the net. If it were to have stayed on the BYU side, then that would still be a live ball they can play.
Correct. BYU cooled off a little bit. They were hitting 833 not long ago. They've dropped 500 points now, hitting 370, which is a huge number, by the way, on the year. They're hitting 357, so they're right around their season average. Hawaii, who is hitting, around 077. They've doubled their hitting average. They're hitting 160 right now. 9 kills and 5 errors. Seiki, 4 kills, no errors, hitting 500, leading the way for the Rainbow Warriors.
What about the team in BYU, second in the MPSF in blocks? They have 4. Hawaii, 8th in the league coming into tonight. They have 3, so hanging with BYU statistically in that category. Stein. 20 serving 22. And it's Joe Worsley, the freshman from Moraga, California. Here it comes. Gets it in again. Set goes outside. Patch, big swing, big time kill. He smits that one up against the far sideline.
Yes, the Hawaii block is basically taking Patch's angle and giving him the line. And he doesn't even care. He says, I'm going to go cross court anyway.
I mean, we hear the phrase elbows over the net. Ben Patch is like chest over the net.
Yes, exactly.
Here's Zarkovic from the back row. Missed it wide. It was there for him, Chris. Unable to take advantage. Good set that time from Jennings Franciscovic.
Yeah, Siki's kicking himself. His first mistake of the night.
And it is Aloha ball here in the first for BYU. Brendan Sander sends it over. Jennings goes outside to Faye from off the net. He's able to handcuff that triple block, but Ben Patch on the second touch goes hard angle, to say the least, for his ninth kill of that opening set. He leads the way. BYU takes it 25-20. They'll swap sides. Set two coming up.
OC Sports, presented on Oceanic Time Warner Cable, is sponsored by Strong. And Hawaii Honda Dealers.
Welcome back. Taking a look at the patchwork performance in that first set. Ben Patch, 9 kills on 12 swings. Nada for errors. He's hitting 750, and BYU takes the first set, Chris, 25-20.
Well, you notice how high he goes. He reaches high, he jumps high. But 9 kills in one set, that's unheard of. He averages 4 to lead the conference. Well, he just simply doubled that in his first set here in the Stan Sheriff Center. Welcome back, Ben.
I mean, we walked out of this arena last week, and we were thinking, okay, this is the best team we've seen, talking about Long Beach State. And TJ DeFalco, just a freshman, we're like, okay, this guy's ridiculous. Best player in the country, easily. And then you see this guy come into the arena, and BYU has now won 31 straight sets as a team. And he makes you think, well, you know, that might be a battle when you debate best player in the country.
I would totally agree. The difference between the two right now, as I see it, TJ DeFalco had 15 digs that last night, plays great floor defense. And I think Ben would say that his strength would be blocking at the net versus four defense in the back. Although he's a decent digger, picked up a couple of digs so far.
4.3 kills per set coming into tonight. Picked up 9 in that first stanza. So lifting that MPSF leading average.
So if Hoyt could just hold him to 5 kills a set, they'd tighten things up quite a bit because they lost, you know, by 4.
One of those easier said than done type of things, right? Here's Sander from the opposite position. Sander has some boosters at 6'4". It looked like he jumped off a trampoline on that attempt.
Well, he's the littlest outside attacker at 6'4", but he plays like he's 6'8", like the other guys, because he's got those great hops.
So 1-0, here it comes from Sander, diving past Kobe Kanetake, well done. Zarkovic from the opposite position. And he's able to flip the script for a Hawaii point.
Kanetake with a great pass here. He's taking both seams, hogging up a lot of court, which he should. Franciscovich was able to give Siki a pretty good set.
And a good serve by Siki outside Langlois. And that goes off of Franciscovich. And out of bounds for a BYU point. Two serving one. The serve by Michael Hatch. And Franciscovich will go backside to Stein. And that is kill number one for Stein von Tilburg on his fifth attempt.
He went 0 for in that first set. A little frustrated there, but look at the block he's facing. 6'9", 6'8", the biggest block he's faced all year long.
So Ian McKellar, the 6'7 junior out of England, with the serve outside. Here's Langlois, and he's able to get it back for BYU. I mean, it's ridiculous what you have to worry about when playing these Cougars, how much they lean so heavily on their pin hitters and how big and skilled they are at those pins. It's not really like anything else you see across the country, as Ben Patch sends that one long.
They don't seem to care if two blockers or three blockers are up. As you say, they just go over blocks.
In fact, they're at the bottom of the conference when it comes to service aces. They're not an acing or scoring service team. At least they haven't been for the majority of this season. They just put it into play and let their big bodies go to work just like that. And that time, Leo Durkin, the 6'4 center, number four, was up and a part of that triple block proposed by BYU.
He sure looks tiny up there, doesn't he? At 6'4"?
Yeah. And so here's Jake Langlois to serve. And he sends that one just long. Good ole job that time by Von Tilburg and Kobe Kanetake in the back row.
Langlois did his mission in Brazil for 2 years.
See the score there. Pepperdine able to pull it off after going down 0-2 on UCSD. They win in five. And UCLA going down a set to UCSB before winning in four. As we see Price Jarman get the side and the point back for BYU. And it will be Jarman retreating back to serve.
Jarman out of Bonanza High School in Las Vegas, Nevada. They won the Nevada State Championship in 2011.
Redshirted last year after a two-year LDS mission to Mexico. Langlois, the triple block was up, and it seems as though whenever Hendrick Mole is in the front row, he gets his palms all over that volleyball.
He does. I'm pretty sure he got that, but I think Jennings Franciscovich might have got a part of that as well.
So we're tied in this second set for the fifth time. We've been tied at every increment. Oh, good pass that time by Sykes. Patch from the back row. What are you gonna do about that? Kill number 10 for Patch.
Well, I think, you think his Superman cape fits? He's wearing it right now. And it's nothing short of amazing.
I think even Superman would be pretty impressed with how high Ben Patch can fly. Almost a shank that time on the first touch by Hawaii. The block was up and the roof on the Zarkovich attempt. As BYU starting to pile the blocks up here as we venture through the early goings of set number two. Seven serving five, Leo Durkin getting it across. The pass by Kobe Kanetake. D set goes to Von Tilburg, and that's going to be a Hawaii point. Kill number two for Stein.
I think Jennings Franciscovich has got to lean a little bit more on Stein now. He's got his first couple of kills. I think he's going to do that to take a little pressure off Zarkovich and Portofe on the outside.
Stein coming in second on the team, 3.53 kills per set. Diving save by Franciscovich. Great save on the Langlois attempt. Faye from the back row, and it's a Hawaii point. He got a piece of the touch of that block.
Well, made that point was a diving save by Jennings Franciscovich. Watch him pop this up, give up his body, pop it straight up. So Hawaii's got to play. Nice set from Siki Zarkovich, and Faye finishes.
And we're tied again. Franciscovich the serve. Langlois from the back row, and he blasts it home.
So they've got so many players who can hit from every position. Tough to get a read on, tough to scout this team. Who do you lean on? Who do you stop? Who do you focus your energy on? I don't think you can really pay a lot of attention to just one player. Or just one tendency.
Yeah. Well, you get in a break, though, on the Sander miss serve. So here comes Siki Zarkovich. Sander the first touch. Set goes middle to Hatch. And he gets it back for BYU. Not accumulating high-frequency kills, averaging just 0.7 kills per set. But again, second in the MPSF in blocks per set. Michael Hatch now back behind the service line. Outside it goes to Faye. Lines up, uncoils, and is able to tool the block to his advantage. And that is an imposing block. We were talking about how high Ben Patch gets. Like we said, it's like pectorals over the top of the tape.
Yeah, he was going up against Price Jarman at 6'9", and Ben Patch at 6'9". That's a big block.
Here comes McKellar, and into the net it goes. Service error number 3 for Hawaii compared to 8 for BYU. Patch soft touches it over. Outside set goes to Fay. The block was late, but it still got there. Bryce Jarman was just trying to get into the room, but he gets there in time to post up the turn back.
Great hustle. Little slide, little shuffle set to the outside. And he makes it just in time, as you said.
11 serving 9. Good pass by Zarkovic. Here's Fay down the line. And in. Point for the Rainbow Warriors. And Kupono Fay, he gets kill number 6. And that's tops on the team tonight.
So BYU taking the line away, and that is his favorite shot. Perhaps they took a little more angle away. They're giving Capone a little more room.
Had to swing at it off the overpass. No good. Langlois now off the block. Diving save. Stein. Here's Fay a second time. Off the block and down. And we're knotted up again here in set number 2.
Even with 3 blockers up, and you see his mom, Shelly, and proud dad, Kyle.
Great effort there by Von Tilburg. Tied for 2nd on the team in digs at 6'8". And here he comes now with the serve, and he pumps it long. An opportunity for Hawaii to take the lead, but they'll have to wait a little bit longer to accomplish that.
Charlie Wade's got to be pleased with this stretch that they have right now. There's been no separation so far. These two teams just trading blows.
Franciscovic goes middle to Mole. Diving save. Sykes. Patch from the back row. Good touch by that Hawaii block. Franciscovic on the second touch with the full swing. Now Fay comes flying in. One hand save over the net by Sykes. Franciscovic goes outside to Fay a second time. Pumped up in the air by Langlois. Set goes to Patch. Off the double block and down. Long rally. Intense sequence. And the punctuation from Ben Patch.
Well, he can celebrate too, can he? And Fay and Pat just trading blows there on that particular sequence. Great volleyball.
13 serving 11. Langlois gets into it. The first touch there by Zarkovic. Now Stein is dug up by Sykes. The bump set by Patch goes to Sander, and he's able to get a decent swing on it. Hawaii comes back with Siki from the back row. Misses wide. Point for BYU, and again, it was tied just moments ago. 3-0 Cougars burst has them breathing a little easy here at this midpoint of this second set.
Siki saw the opening, just barely missed the line.
But a service error helps out this Rainbow Warrior team. Now it's a Wednesday night. This is a team that's lost 6-7. So the crowd maybe not coming out as in force as it would, say, on the upcoming Friday match when these two teams rematch. But there's a pretty good energy in here, I would say, Chris.
I agree. Well, they're seeing some pretty good volleyball.
Sander off the block, saved by Fay. Outside, here's Siki. Had to readjust the jump, and then there was just no chance. That block was eclipsing the lights. And getting the gist of it was Price Jarman. BYU gets the 15 first again.
Big Island Candies, the perfect place to find the perfect gift. Visit them at their flagship store in Hilo, at Ala Moana Center, or online at BigIslandCandies.com to see their amazing selection, including delicious chocolate-dipped shortbreads.
Welcome back. Well, BYU up 15-12 here in the second set, already up 1-0, and the block party has shown up here in Honolulu. BYU totaling 9 blocks, 4 in this second set compared to 4.5 team blocks for Hawaii.
Well, one of the reasons for that is Hawaii's becoming a little bit predictable, Camilla. 28 sets going to the outside, almost 3/4 to 2 people, Zarkovic and Fay. Middles have only gotten 6 sets so far out of 46. Not a high enough number.
Out of the timeout, Hawaii goes to Von Tilburg, and he goes off the block and out. BYU arguing that it may have hit Stein Von Tilburg's heel, but arguing to no avail as Hawaii will serve down 13-15. And Hendrik Moll getting ready to send it across. 6'6 junior from Norway. Here it comes. Pass by Sykes. Set goes to Patch. Oh my goodness. That was incredible.
Patch continues to like that area six going cross court or to the middle of the back row. Gets so high. Just almost like he hovers up there and goes, oh, let's see. Where do I want to hit this next ball?
That was insane.
He's got 12 kills, no errors, and 16 tries.
Zarkovic against the triple block. Great diving save, Kanetake, to keep it alive. Zarkovic a second time tried to avoid the block. And he goes long. Point for the Cougars. And a timeout taken by Charlie Wade and the Rainbow Warriors, and smiles on the BYU side as they take control of this second set. Let's check out the First Hawaiian Bank top three NCAA individual blocks. And Michael Hatch, there in your screen, number two in the nation. We mentioned he's number two in the MPSF. Oftentimes that will parlay into a similar ranking nationally, and that's where Ben Hatch sits. He was a blocking machine. Out of the timeout, BYU sends it long. And Hawaii trailing by three here in this second set. Ben Hatch, Michael Hatch's teammate, has been the one putting on the show tonight, though, Chris. 12 kills on 16 swings, no errors, and doing it in a highlight fashion that is awe-inspiring. There's a swing by Sander, great dig by Franciskovic, and Von Tilburg finishing the sequence. Hawaii back within two.
What a set from Kanetake, way cross court. Von Tilburg starting to feel his oats now. To the follow through by Kanetake, gets it all the way out there. And Tilburg does his thing.
Meanwhile, Jennings Franciskovic sends it into the net. Ill time service error there. And Hawaii, when they have built some momentum, at times tonight they've let BYU off the hook.
Yeah, only five service errors so far, though. I still think they need to keep taking chances.
Sander with the serve, pass Faye. Backside set goes to Siki. He closes the book on that. As Hawaii gets back within two once more. Zarkovic now retreats back to serve.
Great swing by Siki down the line. Perfect set from Jennings Franciskovic.
Siki Zarkovic now surpassing 1,100 career kills as a Rainbow Warrior. Back set goes to Patch. This is getting crazy what he is doing out there. So effortless, seemingly.
I think Hawaii needs to get a couple ladders. With ladders, they can start touching Patch's shots. Ladders, hard to touch. Do you agree?
They're going to have to change the rules and raise the net here for the duration of Ben Patch's career if this continues the way it's going.
13 kills, no errors, 17 attempts, 765 he's hitting.
Backside goes to Von Tilburg, and the block is up. So you got Patch on the offensive side, and then you have the BYU block ever present on the defensive side. That time it was Langlois and Jarman, and another timeout called by Hawaii, finding themselves down four, 20-16 in favor of the Cougars.
Langlois and Jarman, 6'10 and 6'9. That's as big a block as Stein Van Tilburg will see when he plays college volleyball here. I'll tell you, that's huge. And both of them athletic. Both of them jump well. Both of them have good timing.
Yeah. It's one of those, like we were talking last week against Long Beach State, sometimes if you're, say, Charlie Wade and this coaching staff or any real opponent of this BYU or Long Beach State team, depending on what stretch you're seeing them in the season, sometimes you just have to sort of shake your hands and go, well, that's that. They're just better.
Yeah. And I think Charlie Wade's got to be proud, though, that Hawaii's played much better here in the second set. And talking about getting, I think right now he's probably talking about the defenders in the back row getting their feet and their arms properly placed and lining up on Patch a little better. And probably also having the block close a little tighter as well so the defenders can play their defense around the block.
I think that we can be encouraged, though, by this Hawaii effort tonight. They've been putting up a pretty spirited fight so far against a team that is just rolling about on about as high a confidence level as any team coming in here will be. And Hawaii has been able to make things as difficult on them as possible.
Yeah, they've served better to put BYU in some passing difficulty, gotten points that way. They blocked better tonight. They got 4.5 blocks to BYU's 10. Last week they were down 10-0 to Long Beach in blocks. So there have been improvements, to be sure. Right now, BYU hitting 447 on the night, 100 points higher than their normal average.
And Kirio Meditev on to serve for BYU. Here's Kupono Fei from the outside, and he's able to get it down for a Hawaii point. Kupono Fei, another encouraging aspect of this effort by Hawaii tonight. He now has 8 kills on 16 attacks. So Hawaii not out of this second set by any means here. 17 serving 20. This is a guy that can string together some good work behind the service line. Ian McKellar forces a tough pass, but the set goes to Patch. And how many times can Patch up what is otherwise maybe a questionable set off of a questionable first pass?
It is somehow continues to save the Cougars when they're in trouble.
14 kills for Patch, 18 attempts, 0 errors, hitting 778.
Here comes a double sub. Robbie Sutton will be setting. He's going to be the server now. He's going to be the setter. And in the front row is the German, Tim Daubert, the other opposite, number 2, behind Ben Patch.
So Sutton, 6'6 senior, with the serve. Outside set goes to Faye. Roof. By Price Jarman, who was all up in that.
This is like being in the closet. There's no light. It's very dark in there in the closet. No fun, trust
like a,
me.
Like a dungeon. Franciscovic goes middle to Mole. And a good-looking swing that time from Hendrick.
This is something I think that Hawaii's got to do a little bit more of, keep their middles a little more honest. Take some pressure off Hawaii's perimeter pin players.
And Charlie Wade saying, hey, look, we don't need Taylor Averill necessarily in the middle. We just need a little bit more to be able to balance the field a tad. Serving 22. Here comes Von Tilburg. Forces a questionable pass by Sykes, and that will result in an extended, prolonged ace for Stein Von Tilburg.
Even Ben Patch couldn't save them that time. Great serve by Von Tilburg.
So 19 serving 22. Outside it goes to Langlois. Hawaii will have a chance to play this. Franciscovic goes back row to Zarkovic. Blocked. He saves it himself. Now Jennings goes outside to Faye. And that time he got stuffed by Leo Durkin, the setter, in the right place at the right time.
Okay, thank you.
Opportunity missed.
That set is a little bit tight to the net. As Faye has no thing he can do. He can't get a full swing there because it's too tight to the net. All he can do is sort of try to tip it into the block. Hope it comes back softly. Instead, it came back really hard and on his body.
23 serving 19. Here's Langlois. Pass by Kanetake. Middle set, Mole, dug up by Patch. So the bump set will go to Langlois from the back row. Good touch on the block by Hawaii. Franciscovic goes middle to Mole. Caught it fat. Sends it wide. Point BYU. Aloha ball here in the second. This is a Cougar team we mentioned. Bottom of the MPSF in service aces, but their tops in kill percentage, second in blocks. They just want to get the serve in and let these big boys up front go to work. Middle set. Mole! Laying the smackdown.
I love the way that Jennings Franciscovic went right back to Mole, who was mad at himself for missing the last swing. Comes right back at him. gets a one-man block and buries it.
Still Aloha Bowl. But what are you trying to hang in there in this second set? And that's how it will end in anticlimactic fashion. BYU wins the second by the same score of the first, 25-20, and will have a chance to open the broom closet. Welcome back. Let's take a look at the McDonald's match statistics. Chris.
First thing that jumps out is BYU's hitting percentage, 440. You know, over 100 points above their season average. The next thing that jumps out is Hawaii's hitting errors, 16, way too many. That's why they're hitting only 100. And finally, look at the blocks. BYU with 12, Hawaii with 5. That's a big, big difference at the net. I think it's been the between Ben Patch and BYU's blocking. That's the difference in the match.
Yeah, I mean, pretty eye-popping match stats. The Patch stats, though, just as eye-popping. 14 kills on 18 swings. He's hitting 778 with no errors. So how does Hawaii begin to stifle that to any measure?
Well, I think, you know, as Brian and Lisa alluded to, they've got to start probably trying blocking different angles with him rather than blocking all cross court. Maybe try blocking him some line, inviting cross court. Maybe positioning their players in the back row a little differently. Maybe sub in Dalton Solberg, a different middle, to see if he can get a few touches. You're not going to stuff Ben Patch very often. Maybe he'll get a few touches and slow the ball down before it gets to the back court. But on a night like Ben Patch is having tonight, there's really not a whole lot you can do. Like I said, ladders anyone?
Yeah, Hawaii could build a wall. That would be one of the ways you could try to stop.
Well, that's what Trump would do.
That's the theory going around
these days. Make BYU pay for it.
Oh, a little political humor from Chris McLaughlin. You gotta love it. Very timely, my friend. As Siki Zarkovich is able to rattle that one through the proposed BYU block. Hawaii up one serving zero.
You know, one way to get the middles more involved, which is something I think Lisa alluded to, going to Joe Worsley here in the third may result in that, because he loves to set the middles from everywhere.
Secco's backside, and right now it is just Ben Patch's world. That's kill number 15 on 19 attempts. And look at this one. Look how high he gets.
We got to give a lot of credit to Leo Durkin as well, whom Sean Olstead, their coach, says might be their most improved player. Great set.
11th service error, though, for BYU. And it is two serving one. Dalton Solberg in and back to serve. 6'6 freshman. Charlie Wade has continually talked about how impressive he is blocking in practice. And we saw a little bit of that against Long Beach State last week. Outside set. That goes to Langlois. And he ends the Solberg serving threat very quickly.
Patch has been mixing up his floater and his jumper. We'll see what he does here in set three. The jumper.
Oh, just missed the end line. So Hawaii gets it back. Three serving two. They haven't been able to enjoy a lead very much here tonight. So we'll see if they can expand on this. Stein von Tilburg.
Show him down, Hendricks. Show him down. Perfect pass.
Does it surprise you that Patch was the most valuable player in all of Utah when he was in high school?
And that one goes off the block and out. So Hawaii finally did get a pretty firm block on it, but he hit it with such authority that it goes off the block and out beyond the end line. So he is still error-free with 16 kills tonight. Three serving three. Joe Worsley in at the center spot. Goes D-set to Von Tilburg. And Von Tilburg able to tool the block.
Confident swing by Stein. Hasn't had a lot of kills tonight. That's only his fourth of the night. Maybe his fifth. But swinging with a lot of confidence. Once more sets. He's only had 10 so far.
Sander. And he pounds that one to the floor. I mean, you get so revved up trying to anticipate where Ben Patch is at all times, and then here comes the high-flying Brendan Sander. Coming off of two matches against CSUN where he hit 632 over the two matches. Mole from the opposite spot. And Hawaii and BYU trading blows here early in the third. The Cougars up two sets to none. They won each set by the same score, 25-20, which means that they have now ripped off 32 consecutive victories in sets. Here's Patch, the dink, sniffed out by Worsley. Chance for Hawaii here. Set goes to Zarkovic, little off the net. Roll shot, diving save, Sykes. And it'll wind up a Hawaii point.
It all started by the Henrik Mole serve. As I said earlier in the CME's broadcast, if you're going to have success against BYU, you've got to bring it from the service line and put them in passing trouble. Like that.
Patch able to save it out of the seats, and it turns out to be a pretty good set. In fact, a little overpass on the dig by Von Tilburg. Pinball back and forth, and a free ball ends up being the result for BYU. Langlois from the back row pounds it home.
Boy, struggling with their ball handling there. Had some easy plays in transition. Did not pass the ball up where Joe Worsley could get a run a play.
But it was Ben Patch with the back bump set, if you will, saving it out of the front row seats, that kind of kept that rally alive for BYU. In fact, sort of tilted the scales in their favor. Solbrig is blocked.
That was the highlight of the rally, for sure.
Here's Zarkovic, off speeder, pulling the string and getting the Hawaii point.
Since the high velocity swings have been going into the net and getting blocked, why not try an off-speed shot like that? Seeking successful with that.
Outside, Patch, blocked and roof. Solbrig enters the match, and he does what was seemingly impossible, and Hawaii leads by three. Ben Patch denied for the first time tonight. Well, Ben Patch's humanity was finally exposed, even if just for a moment, right before the timeout, as he was blocked by Dalton Solbrig, our Fujitsu Air Conditioning cool play of the match.
And by the way, maybe the coolest celebration. Look at the players are celebrating as if they had just won the match. They finally stopped the guy after 22 tries.
Here's Sander on the backside, dug up by Faye. Kanetake has to go a long way to keep it in bounds, and he does. Free ball here for the Cougars. Seko's backside again to Sander, dug up by Kanetake. Touched in the air by Zarkovic and sent over. Now back row set, and Langlois finally puts an end to all of that.
But the fans applaud the effort. You gotta love that. Even though Hawaii loses the point, they applaud the effort. This is a different Hawaii team tonight than it was last week against Long Beach State. Wouldn't you agree?
I agree with you. I think that's something that even Charlie Wade, despite being down two sets to none, can feel good about. They're putting up a much more spirited effort tonight here against BYU. Here's Zarkovic, dug up by Sykes. Set goes outside Langlois. The block wasn't there. Faye digs it up, but only for a moment. And that will wind up a Cougar point. Good effort again by Kanetake. And coaches, and I would imagine you can speak from experience on this, Chris, they can appreciate, even in a losing effort, if that fight is there, you guys can still appreciate that from the coaching standpoint.
Well, notice who Charlie Wade started tonight. He started with the team. A lot of people were saying, oh, there's so many changes in every position. He unloaded five guys last week in the Long Beach State match. And in practice this week, it was, they're going back and forth, A team, B team. They're all mixed up. Starters are all over the place. And he said to me before the game, you know what? I'm going with the guys who won us the most games this year. And so he went back with that starting group, and they played well, I think. They just can't block that kind of shot, though. Man, pass, give me a break. Yeah, I love what Ryan Tsuji said at the intermission. Ryan Tsuji said, you know what, folks? Come out Friday night. It's worth it to watch a guy like that.
When you can read
high flyer.
When you can read the full name above the net on the front of the jersey,
yes,
that's when you know somebody's getting up.
Yeah.
Here's Von Tilburg. That went off the touch, kept alive by the Cougars. Here's Patch. Off the block, kept alive by Zarkovic. Good second touch, Kanetake set to Siki, and he ends the point. What a play by the Rainbow Warriors.
That was some good volleyball. Some great floor defense. There's the floor defense by Siki, the back bump set by Kanetake, the high hand shot by Siki finishes it. Boy, picks up point number 10.
And Solbrig floats it over. Here is Patch. Just like that, he gets kill number 18.
You know, he's really slipping though. He's hitting, I think he's only hitting 700 now instead of 800.
You're going to have to work on that, I think, in the off day between tonight and the rematch.
Well, I tell you, it's paid off him being in Anaheim playing with the national team since February when he got back from his mission.
Outside, here's Fay. The block hadn't formed, but Sykes all over that swing. Langlois from Whale off the net, and he misses the court wide. Sean Olmsted up off the bench. Palms pointed upward. He thought that that was an in ball. Instead, it's a point for Hawaii. 11 serving 9. Sean Olmsted, first-year head coach on the men's side, was the BYU women's head coach from 2011 to 2014, reached the NCAA final in 2014. But when Chris McGowan resigned last year, Olmsted was moved over to the men's side, as you see the kill by Price Jarman. And interestingly enough, his sister Heather, who was on his staff with the women's program, takes over the women's team.
And their father, an old friend of mine, we played against each other, back in 1969 or so, when he went to BYUH, when it was Church College of Hawaii. And one of the greatest referees in the game, Rick Olmsted, great player as well. Look what his offspring have done in the way of coaching. Amazing.
Kapono Fay, meanwhile, 9 kills for him, putting together a solid performance here tonight, Chris, and Hawaii up 12, serving 10. Very much involved here in the third, looking to extend this match. Sander, he levitated for a moment.
By the way, to finish that thought on Rick Olmsted, he also was Lisa Strand Ma'a's high school coach.
It's like 6 degrees of separation in the volleyball neighborhood.
It really is.
As that serve by Jarman winds up in between. You know, and Sean Olmsted, he has a tie to this building. It was here in 2004 that he was the libero for BYU when they won the national championship against Long Beach State here at the Stan Sheriff Center.
Says he loves this place, has nothing but great memories of the Stan Sheriff Center.
Here's Patch from the back row over a triple block, diving save by Fay to no avail. And another point for BYU, they're back within one.
Even when Hawaii forces a bad pass, a long set like that, a guy like Ben Patch will save you by going up and over a very solid block.
We are seeing another level of this sport embodied by number 13 in white.
He's worth coming out to watch on Friday night, I'm telling you. And I think the Warriors are as well, and they're playing so much better.
Yeah.
And who knows what's going to happen after they watch some film and maybe find a way to start touching a few of Patch's attacks. But meantime, he is worth it.
Worsley goes D-set to Stein. The block was up. Sander getting the gist of that one. Fourth on the team in blocks coming in. And he turns that one back, and we're tied for the fifth time.
Brendan Sander, all MPSF as a freshman last year. He goes up high, hangs, goes over. Preseason All-American choice as well.
Worsley goes middle. Solbrig block, diving save. Kanetake, here's Siki on the outside. And he's able to speed that one through the BYU defense for kill number 11 on 23 attempts. Siki Zarkovic, the senior from Serbia. Worsley tickles the tape. Pass by Sykes. Middle set. That's Hatch. One hand save. Worsley. But nobody at his back for touch number 2.
Not sure if Worsley yelled up there or not, but typically when fast digs like that, especially by the center, if they yell up, everybody turns around. They know that the center's not going to be coming in to set it. Somebody else has got to set it.
Overpass, put down Langlois. So you had Sander with the serve, forcing the bad pass. Langlois gives BYU the lead for the first time in set three. Welcome back. Let's check out how it works, presented by Central Pacific Bank. Chris.
Let's take a look at Henrik Moll on the right side. He's supposed to be lined up in the middle. Instead, he goes to the right. I think BYU wasn't quite ready for it. At this time of the season, almost all of these teams know each other so well. If you throw just a little bit of a wrinkle into your offensive set, you can throw a team off. And I think that's exactly what Hawaii did there. They didn't expect Moll on the right. They expected him in the middle.
Well, he hadn't led through the first two sets at all, led the majority of this third set. It was tied several times, but BYU has taken the lead, and now an ace by Sander puts them up by two. Now, the hitting percentages in this third set, gaudy. BYU at 545, Hawaii at 500. Here's Sander again into the net. It goes. Hawaii needed that. Rainbow Warriors trying to extend this match. BYU, it must be reiterated, has won 10 straight matches and have not dropped a single set. Taking the first two tonight, that's now 32 straight sets they've won. Can Hawaii end that streak? Pass by Sykes, set outside. It's Langlois.
The BYU streak started on January 29th, so for the entire month of February, didn't lose a set.
Yeah, last time they lost a set, they actually lost three to Long Beach State. That was on the 23rd of January. Long Beach State, the number one team in the country, which BYU had defeated in the previous meeting of that series in four sets. And that's a big-time block. Price Jarman sends it right back into Siki Zarkovich's grill.
Watch how they just wait. They're very patient. They know that there may be that big set out of the back row. They were not fooled at all.
One hand set by Worsley to Solbrig, and that was a thing of beauty.
Now that kind of play will set up the back row quick. Now, you know, Worsley's got to hope that BYU middle blockers will start jumping with Hawaii's middle attackers.
Jennings Franciscovich getting the start at setter tonight for Hawaii, but as expected, Joe Worsley getting some run out there. And BYU, once again, getting the side back. Bryce Jarman. What do you think about the differences between Joe Worsley and Jennings Franciscovich? The size is obviously the most obvious difference. Franciscovich at 6'5", also has some tremendous jumping ability. Joe Worsley at 6 feet.
And who has the... And Franciscovich with the most jumping ability touches, you know, around 12 feet. But, you know, one of the biggest differences is I think Worsley likes to set the middle a little bit more. But they're very, very close in their abilities. And I think clearly Worsley's more of a liability at the net because of his size. Franciscovich, an excellent blocker. You know, they each bring something different to the table.
Von Tilburg getting ready to serve. 17 serving 19. Set goes outside. Langlois denied by Henrik Moll. Saying, oh, no, you don't.
Henrik Moll, a little bit of hang time there. He goes up, moves well to the outside. And he just at the last second, he's able to tap the ball back down. Great shot.
Four blocks for Henrik Moll here tonight. A serve by Stein. Set goes to Patch over the double block, dug up over the net, and just wide of that sideline. So another kill for Ben Patch. He's got 20, hitting 7-0-4. Putting on a performance for the ages here at the Stan Sheriff Center. Pass tight to the net, and it's going to be a Hawaii point. They're going to say that Sanders interfered.
Hawaii hanging in there. been within one or two points the entire set, and even led most of the first half of the set for those who just joined us.
19 serving 20. Set goes backside to Patch. And that one, hey look, when you're good, sometimes you even get the fortunate bounces. That one sort of crawled across the top of the tape for a split second before finding its way down to the Terraflex on Hawaii's side.
Yeah, that set wasn't the perfect one for Patch, so he just sort of, he did one of those hit and hope shots and got some cable and got it to go down. But he's having, as you said, that kind of a night.
Make it 21 kills for him, and here's Kirill Meritev serving for BYU. Pass by Faye. Worsley goes high and away to Siki. Dug up by Langlois. Here's Sander on the outside. Again, speeds it past the diving effort of Stein von Tilburg, and Charlie Wade is relegated to calling a timeout, seeing his Hawaii team down three late in set three. Each set has kind of taken on a similar personality, if you will, where BYU has kept it tight with Hawaii and vice versa, but it has been about this juncture of each set where the Cougars have been able to create separation.
Exactly. You know, it's got to be frustrating for Charlie Wade right now is that, you know, at one point in the third set, they were hitting 500, and you think if you're hitting 500, you're going to be doing pretty good, but you're playing against a team that was hitting 512 at the time. Right now, BYU hitting 517, siding out of 84% clip. 70 is good. Hawaii siding out at 72. That wins most matches in the MPSF, and right now they're playing up against a team that's siding out 12 percentage points higher. So it's got to be very, very frustrating for Charlie Wade and his staff.
Let's check in with Ryan.
Hey, thanks, guys. Well, moments ago, we showed you the how it works and opportunities kind of take you into the game. Well, Hawaii now finds themselves in that same situation that we just highlighted moments ago. They're in rotation five with Hendrick Moe in the right front position. Hawaii looking to split their hitters and have Hendrick Moe hit a high ball potentially once again, just how they did moments ago. BYU, on the other hand, warning their players that could potentially be happening. We'll see coming out of this timeout. Back to you guys.
Cat and mouse game, the chess match that goes on within the respective huddles during these timeouts. We'll see how it plays out here on the floor. BYU up three late and closing in on a sweet victory. Ben Patch has been the story, 21 kills, hitting 714 to lead BYU. Zeke Zarkovich, 11 kills to lead the Rainbow Warriors. The serve by Meritev. Here's Moe, there it was.
It worked again. You know, BYU was warned about it. They knew about it from the last time that Moe was in that rotation. Still couldn't stop him. That was a great little wrist away shot down the line. He's a great beach player, by the way. You know, he played for Norway. His mom played in the Atlanta Olympics, Mom Marita. Henrik on the Norwegian national team for beach volleyball.
He's now back to serve. 20 serving 22, gets it in. Set goes high and away. Sander with another demonstrative smash. So we've been talking about Ben Patch and his 21 kills. Well, Langlois has 13 kills hitting 308. Sander, 7 kills hitting 250. They've done their part for sure in complement to Ben Patch and his heroics. As that serve drifts long from Leo Durkin, much needed point for Hawaii. 21 serving 23. Joe Worsley back to serve.
Well, even with BYU giving Hawaii 17 service errors, Hawaii still struggling to at least get a set off them.
Here it comes. Pass tight to the net, and it's going to be a Hawaii point. They're going to rule that one a violation by the setter, Leo Durkin.
Leo Durkin reaching over the net on Hawaii's side of the net, bringing the ball back to the BYU side. Point Hawaii.
So Hawaii within a single digit. And Joe Worsley, Diablo Foothill Athletic League MVP at Campolindo High School out of Moraga, California, with the serve. And Langlois again with his 14th kill And he pushes Hawaii to the brink. 24-22. It will be Aloha ball on the other side of this timeout.
Hard to believe that Mangalai did not play high school volleyball. Was the MVP golfer in his high school and played some soccer. And at 6'10", decided, I think I'll go try out for volleyball at BYU, one of the best teams in the country. And he makes it, obviously, yeah. And he's worked his way up to be a pretty darn good volleyball player.
Has become a reason why they are one of the best teams in the country. And as is the case with so many of these BYU student athletes, he comes from a BYU family. Dad Douglas played volleyball at BYU. Sister played rugby at BYU. So, you know, this is...
Her brother-in-law that played football.
There you go. So, you know, this is a long-standing tradition with this program. It runs deep. The roots run deep. The lineages continue on. And Jake Langlois, once again, providing so much for BYU here at the Stan Sheriff Center tonight.
He's been great blocking at the net. He's going over blocks, around blocks. 13 kills, only 5 errors, hitting 308 on the night. And got 5 digs to boot. Almost as many as Sykes. Sykes leads with 7, but Langlois with 5. Proving that he can play the back row as well, even at 6'10". There's another large guy in the audience who's even larger than Langlois. Sean Bradley at 7'6" is watching tonight's game here at the Stan Sheriff Center. There he is, Big Sean. Had a great career at BYU at basketball, and not sure why he's here. He must be related to one of the players. He must be an uncle or something of one of the players.
Yeah, it could be. Maybe it was just kismet. Maybe the family was vacationing here in the islands. BYU in town. He wanted to check out a volleyball match. Who knows? Here's Siki with Hawaii trailing by 2 on Aloha ball. Allows them to tread water for at least an extra sequence.
And Sean Bradley had a sister that played here, Adrian, way back in the day. But she's not here, so he's got to have some reason for being here. But looks like he's having fun like everybody else.
If only we had a sideline reporter or some other members of our crew that could go over and find out. Here's the serve by Zarkovic on Aloha ball. Here's Patch to try to end it. Unable to do so there. Free ball coming. Siki's got to get it over. Advantage Cougars can end it. Patch does. This one is Pau.
Superhuman. Worth the price of admission. In the zone. 22 kills, 1 error. It's 700. That's more than you, Kanoa Leahy.
A heroic effort from Ben Patch as he puts on display in front of these Stan Sheriff Center fans an effort that embodies the future of collegiate volleyball. Ben Patch was magnificent. 22 kills, 700 as you mentioned, and BYU makes it 11 straight without a loss in a single set. Let's take a look at the Bank of Hawaii. Players of the match. Ben Patch, we should uptick that to 22. Again, 22 kills on 30 swings, 1 error, hitting 700, 3 blocks, 3 digs. Siki Zarkovic, you gotta love the effort from these Rainbow Warriors as they put up a legitimate fight in each set. But it was not meant to be for the Rainbow Warriors. 12 kills for Siki, hitting 231, 2 blocks, and 5 digs.
Yeah, I would totally agree. A spirited battle by Hawaii. Coaching staff had them ready to go. Players played hard all night long. Hawaii did everything they could. They ran into a buzzsaw again, though. Last week, TJ DeFalco. This week, Ben Patch.
Let's check in with Scott Robbs.
Thanks a lot, guys. I'm with Coach Charlie Wade. Charlie, somebody maybe want to request a DNA test of Ben Patch because that guy's not human.
Yeah, you know, I'm thinking, can we maybe like take like Ko'olawe or something and get our own, like send every guy on a mission for 2 years? Because he was good before he left, but that was an impressive performance, no doubt.
You know, it didn't seem like you guys played poorly tonight. It's just that they were at another level.
Yeah, you know, I get asked periodically, what's the difference between coaching men's and women's volleyball? I coached for a long time. At one point during that, we're siding out at 80% and hitting 500 and losing. that's the significant difference. That you can play at a really high level, and you just may find a team like that that there's, we just didn't have an answer for one guy. You know, the other guys we held in check for the most part. So hats off to them. And like I say, there's some positive stuff on our side, so we're back at it here on Friday.
You guys are obviously in a bit of a funk, and I noticed tonight you were talking a lot more and trying to encourage the guys. Is that part of the reason?
Yeah, and I wouldn't even say the funk. Like I said, I thought we played pretty good tonight. If you're in our practice gym and you're at, in the locker room, I mean, these guys are still working hard and really into it. So, I mean, nobody likes losing. You know, we're saying, you want to have some fun? Well, winning's fun. The losing is not fun at all, and it pisses us off to no end. But, the guys are still battling. You know, and Scott, let me take a second. I got to send a shout-out or just send my condolences to, I'm sure people heard today about Kim Willoughby and the tragic. And, I mean, it really puts something like this in perspective. You know, my guys are battling their acoles off every day. And, you know, we're just trying to teach them some life lessons and how fortunate we are to live in this state and have this kind of support. And when something like that comes down where somebody who is such a great athlete, one of the best athletes in Hawaii athletics history, and to see a tragedy like that, it's just heartbreaking. So, our prayers are with her and her family and, it's just, like I said, it kind of puts all this in perspective.
Well said, Coach. Thanks.
A lot.
All right, guys, back over to you.
Thank you, Scott. And we would like to reiterate, certainly, the aloha sent to a member of the Hawaii volleyball family, Kim Willoughby, dealing with a horrific family tragedy. And so we send our prayers and our love and our aloha to a member of this Hawaii volleyball ohana. And in a different situation, we'd like to also extend our aloha to Heather Boyan of the sand volleyball program, suffering an accident while hiking and suffering a bad injury there. So we wish her the best as well. As the discussion pertains to tonight's match, Ben Patch was fun to watch, even if you were rooting for Hawaii, because you just don't see volleyball played at that level very often. Even the aunties. Maybe they're lecturing him on, hey, this is how you don't play that well in two nights. How about that? But he was spectacular. Hawaii has to suffer a loss despite putting up a fight, as Charlie Wade said, and they now fall to 10-8, 5-8 in the MPSF conference. So they have 48 hours to try to figure something out here against these Cougars. What do they do in that time?
Well, I think they don't they don't give up the ship. You know, they've got to keep battling. And like Charlie said, at one point they were hitting 500, siding out at 80%. Those are huge numbers. But they're playing against a team that has better numbers and a guy who's just on fire. They got to hope that Ben Patch maybe shows up and isn't quite as good on Friday. I mean, 7 kills per set, that's crazy. Almost double his normal output. So maybe he'll have his normal output on Friday, and Hawaii can have a chance. It'll make a big difference, for sure.
We'll see if the aunties maybe try to pull off a little voodoo there on Ben Patch. As my aunties would say, giving him the coubrants before the Friday match, the rematch between these two teams. But it was a lot of fun, and that will wrap it up for us, Hawaii on the losing end. BYU winning 11 straight. They're now 15-2, 11-2 with the MPSF. Stay tuned for the post-game show for Chris McLaughlin. I'm Kanoa Leahy. See you Friday, everybody. Aloha.